Being Latin, that means I'm loud and boisterous and, you know, forward charging and whatever. And I think all of that is great. It's actually core to who I am. The fact that I'm a Cuban American is also really important to me because I see the importance of being a Latina voice in the workplace. We're in a remarkable moment at time in the advertising business where we've never seen the velocity of change and transition in our business. And we've been preparing to meet that moment for years. At Disney, we're committed to inspire a better world through the power of stories. It's how we've reflected families across all of our content, LGBTQ, Black, Latino, AAPI, et cetera. You start to see a different picture of what a normal family looks like. My teams and partners make me a better business leader and understand the value and the unique experiences that they bring to the table. We need to see more women of color in the C-suites. We need to see more women of color on boards. It's really important that you don't apologize for what makes you unique and lean into that and make it your superpower. I want to make sure that the generation that comes behind me can see themselves. I want people to say, you know, she was a leader who cared about people. Integrity is everything. This is about business relationships anchored in trust.
Please join me in congratulating the president of Disney Advertising Sales, Rita Ferro.
That was awesome. You were so good.
That was amazing. Hi, everybody. Thank you, Kelly. That was so incredible. She's always so great. She gets nervous, and she's the best at it. Kelly's my role model and my inspiration. She's a terrific leader, a mom, an advocate. Best-selling author, you guys are gonna know that, a great producer, and most importantly, the absolute best thing that's happened to morning television. Thank you to the Matrix Board for this incredible recognition. Thank you to Women in Communications, New York Women in Communications, for always advancing the next generation of female leaders. I love this night. This is an honor to be among these extraordinary women who are powerful and badasses. I'm humbled to be included among this group, some who've been friends for years, Tiffany and Elizabeth, and some who I got to meet tonight, and Devika, Marley, Judy, Stephanie, and of course, Gwen Stefani. And as I said to Gwen when I came in, when I found out she was a nominee, I had to realize, holy moly, I have to up my wardrobe game. I think I overdid it with the sequence, I'm not gonna lie. Before I start, two of my biggest champions are here, my husband, Vahe, and my daughter, Tatiana, who are the loves of my life and are my biggest cheerleaders always, and I'm so thankful that you're here today to be with us and my team. I love you both. And thank you to the Disney crew, this crew right here, who are the absolute best people in the business, and for sure, one of the reasons I'm standing here today. Women are an unstoppable force, and as we rise, we must remember to lift. I wear a number of hats at Disney, but one that I'm most proud of is leading a committee of diverse women, Latinas, and women of color at the company. While more opportunities are opening up across the workplace, and it is diversifying, often the biggest roadblocks are not those in the company, but the ones we face internally. Those feelings that tell us that we're not enough, the feelings of guilt, the voices in our head that make us think that we're not worthy. As I've heard from several of these Latina mentees, it's also the voices that tell them that don't take time out of your day to develop your career because you have to take care of your family, or how we need to focus on our jobs and not be networking for our future. Enough, enough. We have to lean into the power of and. To have the courage and the support to say mom and coworker, Latina and boss. When we look ahead at the incredible generation of girls, and I saw so many here, just like my beautiful daughter, Dati, we'll evaluate progress not just by what the workforce looks like, but also women in leadership positions and their self-confidence index. For women in every industry, I want that to be off the charts. There's an idea that self-confidence can't be taught, You have to, you either have it or you don't. I'm here to tell you, self-confidence can be nurtured, and it needs to be part of leadership. I want women coming up behind us to have it easier than we did, to feel empowered, supported, where parity is a given, you don't have to fight for it. Opportunity with encouragement is what's represented here tonight, and what a gift tonight is. Throughout my career, I've had many things that I've talked about with many of, you know, my colleagues, my friends, and they've been transformational for me. And there are things that I share with Dati from time to time, and I'd like to share some of them with you guys. Let's call them the Ferro Five. The first is, you are enough. Everybody has the ability to win, because we all have that opportunity. Don't be afraid of financial success. As women, as Latinas, as people of color, we're often thinking we're not good enough and we're not worthy. Oh, baby, are you worthy? Every person tells a story of what he or she believes in their actions. So celebrate the losses as much as the wins and learn from them. Don't envy the success of others. Borrow from the best and encourage others to rise to that level. And most importantly, please don't be threatened by the success of other women. We need all of us to win. There's plenty of room. And the last one is give back. Give time, give money, share the blessings that you have received because they give you more than you will ever, ever, ever imagine. Opportunities and seats at the table are important, but not enough. It's our responsibility to bring people along and continue to mentor and nurture them in every step of their career. I am living proof that that works. Thank you to my fellow nominees and winners, and keep continuing to break down barriers and push forward for the next generation of talented women following in your footsteps. Thank you so much.